morning. Today's agenda is coming to you live from the Gangaram Hospital. And the reason that we are coming live from here is because this hospital has become the center of the crisis of chikungunya and dengue. In fact, some breaking news coming in as Dr. Rana, who is the head of Gangaram Hospital, is telling us that till now we've known 4 deaths. Dr. Rana told us that in just the last 1 hour, we've lost another patient. So 5 people have died here in the capital because of chikungunya. The deaths started happening yesterday morning. 5 deaths have occurred already. We'll be speaking to the doctors over here. We've got a large panel of doctors from Gangaram Hospital, from Apollo, from All India Institute of Medical Sciences, and we have some families over here as well, whose wards are admitted at the hospital behind me. The ICU is just behind me and people are really, really worried. And instead of tackling this crisis, how are the administrators dealing with it? Just take a look at the blame game and the politics that's been taking place. Take a look.
Corporations safai nahi kar rahe aur jaan boojh ke aisa lagta hai Delhi ke andar mahamari phailana chahte hain. Un logon se main kehna chahunga ki agar dengue ka mchhar kaatega to unko bhi kaatega. ये दिल्ली के अंदर दिल्ली के जितने भी लोग हैं उसके साथ ये बदला क्यों लेना चाहते हैं समझ से बाहर है. देखिए पहली बात तो मैं आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करना चाहूंगा पैनिक बिल्कुल ना फैलाएं. सबसे बड़ा ये मीडिया का क्रिएटेड पैनिक है और मीडिया को कहते हैं सुपारी दी जाती है कि आप उठा के इसको पैनिक बनाइएगा.
संवेदनशील चुनी हुई सरकार को गंभीर होना चाहिए और आरोप प्रत्यारोप में नहीं फंसना चाहिए. समय है कि हम दिल्ली की जनता की सेवा करें. केंद्र सरकार की ओर से पूरी सपोर्ट हमारी है. जो सपोर्ट चाहिए होगा वो हम देंगे.
सो इट्स योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एंड इफ हुएवर यू मे हैव टू गो टू टेक देयर हेल्प इन यू नो प्रिवेंशन इट हैज टू बी डन. फॉर इंस्टेंस ऑल द हॉस्पिटल्स आर विद देम. हाउ कैन यू ब्लेम देम. एवरीथिंग इज डन कलेक्टिवली. व्हेन यू आर इन गवर्नेंस यू नो यू टॉक विद ईच अदर.
एल जी साहब कहाँ पर हैं, कहाँ गए हैं और क्या करने के लिए गए हैं? दिल्ली के 3 मेयर हैं नगर निगम के और नगर निगम की जिम्मेदारी थी कि मच्छरों की जनसंख्या ना बढ़े. तीनों के तीनों मेयर कहां पर हैं और क्या कर रहे हैं? इस बार मच्छरों को मारने के लिए दवा का छिड़काव नहीं हुआ दिल्ली में.
यू कैन नॉट स्पेंड 10 रुपीज. मोस्ट ऑफ योर मिनिस्टर्स टुडे आर इन फॉरेन डेस्टिनेशन और डेस्टिनेशन अदर देन दिल्ली. हूज मनी इज इट दैट दे आर स्पेंडिंग? यू हैव टू आंसर दिस पर्टिनेंट क्वेश्चन.
So some breaking news coming in. We've just been told by the Gangaram doctors that a 5th person has died in Delhi and he was 70 plus, also from Delhi. Remember, Aam Aadmi Party has said that some of the people, the deaths can't be attributed to the conditions here because some of the people were 2 of the people. One was from Aligarh, one was from Ghaziabad. Now the health minister has also had a press conference in which he said that he believes, and the AIMS doctors have told him, that chikungunya can't claim or can't be fatal, can't cause death. Dr. Rana, in last 1 hour, you've said that the 5th patient has died in your hospital. Now, what would you say to the health minister who says chikungunya can't kill?
We also are aware that probably chikungunya is not causing death. That is what we are given taught. But what I want to say that I cannot really say, establish relationship between disease and death, you know. But all these people, all these patients presented with high grade fever and all symptoms of chikungunya, and they were strongly positive for chikungunya done by PCR method, you know. But we are calling for since 1st September, you know. In our hospital we are doing now all tests for such patient by PCR, and PCR is showing a lot of almost 60% patients, suspected patients, they are positive for this chikungunya. While we were doing the previous test by IgM only, then I can just say in last 1 month, test done by IgM on 355 patients, that was reported nearly in our hospital.
Okay. Now before we have Atishi Marlena from AAP, we have RP Singh from BJP. Before we speak to all of them, and of course the doctors are here to clear up the thing, I think the most worrying is for everybody watching at home, people who have fever, people are scared, who are getting ill. Now, we have some people over here whose wards are admitted in the hospital. Sir, aapki wife hai?
Yes.
She's in hospital.
She's in hospital.
And tell us the problems that you've encountered because of a chikungunya. Was screening very difficult? Was diagnosing it very difficult?
No, it was diagnosed on a 9th of this month. And she was admitted yesterday night at 10 o'clock. We remained in the emergency. There is no bed. So ultimately we got a bed in the medicine department under Dr. Atul treatment, Atul Kakkar treatment. She has the problem of protein level has jumped up immediately.
Okay. And so when you hear Aam Aadmi Party, BJP fighting with each other, how do you feel?
They are useless people. They are only vote bank, that's all. They are not bothered about the people. They are not bothered about the general public.
There's another person over here who has... okay, well, he's just going to come...
They're making false statements.
Atishi Marlena, you just heard someone whose wife is admitted, and the people are very upset about the political statements that they're seeing over there, especially the denial that chikungunya can be fatal. How do you respond to all these concerned people?
First of all, I absolutely do understand there is a very worrying health situation in Delhi, and we on behalf of the Delhi government have been trying to provide as many facilities as possible in Delhi government hospitals, increasing the number of beds, providing free testing for dengue, for chikungunya, and these facilities are being provided on an everyday basis in Delhi government hospitals, and we are ramping up facilities from this moment onwards. However, the unfortunate state of affairs does exist in Delhi. You do have the fact that one government, which is the MCD, is responsible for public health, for preventive health, and you have another government, which is the Delhi government, responsible for curative health. While we can take responsibility for ensuring that curative health measures are ensured, the point of the fact of the matter is that dengue, chikungunya, malaria is caused by mosquitoes, and you do need to clear the garbage and you need to do fogging in the city. So my request goes out to the MCD, my request goes out to all the officials, all the mayors,
that this is something and about dengue has been existing for a few days now. I just wanted to ask you that the scare has been on for a few days. A lot of people have reported the growing incidents, and of course you've been in the establishment, you would know that much more. Do you think in such a circumstance it was wise, and you know, it looked like the government didn't care with the health minister away in Goa looking after the prospects, political prospects of another state, in another state, instead of tackling things over here? And nobody was here today.
Two things. First of all, the chief minister is out of Delhi for a health matter himself. Number two, the health minister was away for only 2 days. However, for the past couple of months, arrangements, he was out only for 2 days. I'm just pointing that out. The health ministry has been ramping up all the facilities in Delhi government hospitals. If you were to go into any Delhi government hospital, you will see separate wards for chikungunya and dengue patients. You will see facilities for testing. Even now, we are looking to increase the number of beds. We have opened 262 clinics. So my request to all of you is that I think we all need to come together. We'll request the media also to ensure that no situation of panic gets created in Delhi. Because I think that if people panic in this situation, then the pressure on our hospitals would increase even further. And this is exactly what happened last year, that 60% of the people who got admitted for dengue actually did not need to be admitted but reached there in a panic situation. So I think the message should everyone should be that please, if you get ill, go to your physician, but do not get in a situation of panic.
Dr. Bedi, you blame the government. You feel that there's been some kind of mishandling. You heard what the spokesperson said just now about all the measures that they've taken. How would you, do you still disagree?
I think Virchow, who is considered the father of modern community medicine, about a century and a half said that socio-economic problems are the root cause of public health. Public health cannot be handled at the health issue. Now, I think post-independence India, we have always outsourced our health thinking to either international NGOs or UN agencies, and they have their own priorities. For example, for 6 months we got a headache listening to Zika virus, and we've not been warned against chikungunya and dengue, and this, and once outbreak occurs, the social conditions won't. Once the point is the infrastructure was systematically messed up for decades, And now, for example, another thing I want to add, it may not be fatal in able adults,
okay.
But chikungunya is generally a South India virus. It's new for the North Indians. So we do not have inherently very good immunity to it. But it is nearly fatal for the fetus. So pregnant women have to be extremely, extremely careful in this.
So major warning there for
all
people.
Pregnant women, yes.
Pregnant women, because, but we are seeing a lot of people who are
RNA virus,
who are affected.
It's an RNA virus which gets into the fetus in no time.
Yeah.
And it is an overwhelming virus in the fetus.
Okay, so before we get into the specifics, and I know lots of people have questions, we have a lot of families over here. RP Singh, I wanted to tell you that the BJP immediately, attacked the government and said that why aren't there any ministers here? You can't blame the LG. However, they have pointed out another thing. The part of the cleaning process is the civic authorities, and the civic authorities in Delhi is handled by the BJP.
Now, coming back to the issue where you started from, that who all are missing? The deputy CM is away to Finland. CM is away to Bangalore.
Yeah, I asked him that, but I'm saying that
give me. No, they're not missing. I'll tell you what they're doing. The health minister is away to Goa campaigning. The other minister is away to Raipur. Another minister is away to Hajj. So out of the seven ministers, six are missing. So who's going to take charge of Delhi?
I'm asking you another question.
I'm coming to that.
Yeah.
For person, what is the priority? It's nothing that which is now. The news happening. So Goa is a priority or Delhi is a priority? And coming to that MCD. MCD, there are 12 vans of MCD which are going from each cluster. I am saying JJ clusters for that reason, because there are more reasons there. And giving free tests and giving free medicines also.
But
give me a minute. Now I am making a request, now positive suggestion here. I am requesting Delhi government, please allow that test to be free for Delhiite. People who are making 10,000 rupees a month can't afford a test of 1,600 rupees or 4,000 rupees. Please give that test free to Delhi for everyone, not only in government hospital, even if some go to the private hospital. Give me a minute, ma'am. Also, and let me give you an example. Last year, Maharashtra government, last year, every patient who suffered from dengue went to any hospital, including Gangaram, was given a treatment free for the hospital.
I want to ask, your aunt went through this, right? She's just recovering. Does she have to pay for testing or was it free? Did she go to a private clinic?
No, she went to AIMS. So there it was free. And her father, even he suffered after that. He's in the ICU because of chikungunya. It triggered some sort of kidney problem and some sort of neurological problem. He's still in the ICU since the last 4 years.
Dr. Dang, most of the people, they come to the laboratory first. What kind of, are you seeing? AAP tells us, look, it's nothing to, it's the media which is creating the panic. As someone who's been there, who's seen it through the years, who do you think is responsible here, and should everyone be worried, or are we actually making too much of something which is routine for this time of the year?
It's a combination of both. Since the last 10 years, every year I am on this forum, and there's panic created, more panic than what it should be. But on the other hand, this disease actually should not be there at all. Why? You said the government is prepared. You say the tests are being done free in government hospitals. I would just like to ask one question. Were we prepared to start doing the real-time PCR before the monsoons came? No, not at all. As Dr. Rana rightly said, that Gangaram, V, Max, lots of hospitals and labs are doing the real-time PCR. But are the government hospitals, or were the government hospitals till about a month back equipped well enough to diagnose the disease? No. They were doing either by the ELISA method or looking for the IgM antibodies, which become positive much later in the disease. Why was the RT-PCR not introduced much earlier, when we anticipated and when we knew that we can have an onslaught of any of these viruses soon enough? So at the moment, the situation is that the patients are panicking. Any kind of a fever, the patients are coming and getting themselves tested. Yes or no? But the fact remains that the fear lurks in the mind of the common man. And that is what has to be taken care of. And I think instead of having a knee-jerk reaction again this year, we should be preparing ourselves for the next year. And what I'm hearing, I'm not in the studio at the moment, that it's only the buck is being passed on from one agency to another. Who is bothered whether it's MCD or Delhi government? I as a common man, we as a common public, when we step out onto the roads and this filth and dirt and dirty sewer and drain and blocked everything, are we bothered whether it's because of the MCD or because of the Delhi government? Whichever hospital we go to, we don't care. We want the best for all of us, for all the citizens of Delhi.
I think that is not what is being provided. You really speak for all of us when you say that. Well, you really speak for all of us when you say that. And without sounding alarmist, I just want to quote figures from public figures to say that till now, this year, 12,255 cases of chikungunya have been reported, and according to the government and according to public figures and according to the Department of Health, that's the worst in 5 years. So there's no panic being created by us. We're just reporting what's there. And Atishi, Marlena, would you like to respond to what Dr. Dang has said, that why is it? Because even JP Nadda, the Central Health Minister, pointed out that these advisories, that it's coming around, please prepare. Why wasn't it done in advance?
There is a lot of preparation in advance that has gone into preparing for this time of year when you do have this situation of dengue, of chikungunya, of malaria. And if you do go to any Delhi government hospital, which is unfortunately the only hospitals over which we have any authority, you would find that a lot of preparation is already in place. Unfortunately, and as Dr. Dang has rightly pointed out, for an ordinary citizen, it doesn't matter. I want to go to a hospital, and for me it should be working. I don't care if it's MCD, if it's central government, or if it's Delhi government. But as a government, I think we can only take charge of our own hospitals. What I would want, however, is, as we have Mr. R.P. Singh here, I think what we do really need is far more cooperation from the MCDs. And at this point of time, Delhi government is willing to give any cooperation that the MCDs need to support them. Because the thing is that at this point, fumigation, farming, etc. is extremely important.
I would like to say through your channel that you need not to be panicked. If any patient is having high-grade fever with joint pain, headache and rashes, they have to come immediately to the hospital, and they have to go nearest doctor or nearest doctor available to their home, and they have to just take plenty of fluids. If there is high-grade fever, they have to take paracetamol, they have to do hydrotherapy. Masses, don't take any painkillers.
No painkillers. And also,
and as early as
possible, just insect repellent.
Insect repellent.
Okay.
And one more thing.
We're going to have lots
just,
more advice.
Just rule out dengue.
We're going to take a short break. Come right back with all our doctors and just clear up all the doubts, because what people are warning is that the worst may be yet to come in the case of dengue and chikungunya. So stay with us. Welcome back. There have been 5 deaths till now of chikungunya in the capital. However, Aam Aadmi Party government has said that they doubt whether it's all caused by chikungunya, and they want to calm everyone down. They think it's a lot of panic, so a lot of political bickering has been happening. There are some people with me whose families are admitted. Aapke papa hain, father hain. Now, when you hear sare politicians yahan pe BJP keh rahi hai ki aapka problem hai, aapke ministers nahi hai, aap keh rahi hai ki BJP aur LG case pe, to aapko aap us pe kaise react karte hain unki baatein sunke?
Madam, Aam Aadmi Party ne to business bana rakha hai.
Kis tarike ka business? Aise kyun keh rahe hain aap?
Kyunki wo kuch unko koi care se koi insaan se matlab nahi hai, chahe wo kuch bhi ho, unhe koi lena dena nahi, koi kaam nahi hai abhi tak.
Adishi Marlena, this is not a politician, this is someone whose father is admitted here at hospital. How do you respond to this?
Well, see, absolutely. I think that for an ordinary citizen, as I've said, for an ordinary citizen of Delhi, and Dr. Dang pointed this out beautifully, I think for an ordinary citizen, it does not matter whether a hospital belongs to the MCD, whether it belongs to Delhi government, whether it belongs to the central government, whether the cleaning of the garbage dumps or the dhalaos is the responsibility of MCD or Delhi government, an ordinary citizen doesn't care. But unfortunately, Delhi is in such a governance mess that it is extremely difficult to resolve these problems till this governance nightmare is sorted out. Because finally, it is the citizens of Delhi for whom all governments need to work. It's the citizens of Delhi for whom the MCDs need to work, for whom the Delhi government needs to work, and the central government also needs to work. Until there is this active non-cooperation from the central government and MCD ends, Delhi government towards its best efforts can't do very much about it.
Atishi, I'm going to interrupt you. Just as you're speaking, the health minister who came back from Goa where he was campaigning, he's now meeting patients over there. The doctors want to say something. Are we seeing, because it's been called the worst outbreak in the last 5 years, are we seeing it? Is it a different strain of it? Yeah, go ahead.
Well, chikungunya possibly not a different strain. Maybe virulence keeps on changing. All the virus, this is the quality of a virus to change its antigenicity, okay. Which is known to happen. Like that's why many viruses to make a vaccine become difficult because they change their
character. And have you seen the worst or?
Probably we are seeing the tip of an iceberg. If our methodology of picking up cases is put in the right mode, you will see that we are having more cases. Otherwise, if you try and only depend on IgM-based serologies, yeah. It is misleading us.
Okay, so that sounds ominous with so many, we're totally out of time. Just one line.
One small thing. Yeah. I'm requesting Atishi again, please, instead of spending your 526 crore rupees on your campaign, this person would have paid 1.5 lakh rupees for a day and a half treatment for his father. He can afford, but what would a poor man who voted for you?
Okay.
Please give that, allow
okay.
that treatment
we're,
free
we're
for
totally
everyone.
We're out of time. We're just hoping that whether it's the Aam Aadmi Party, which handles Delhi government, or the civic authorities, which is handled by BJP, they all get their act together so that all these people who are here at hospital, their concerns get attended to. Thanks to all the doctors on our panel and to everyone else. Thanks very much for watching. Goodbye.